Joining us now is MSNBC legal analyst Nick Ackerman, a former assistant U.S. attorney for the Southern District of New York. He was an assistant Watergate special prosecutor. Nick, we've been talking about this since the first inklings of that meeting last June. This is kind of interesting, first of all, that if one got that email, that one wouldn't remember getting that email, because we don't all generally get emails from WikiLeaks with an encryption key and a website that has lots of juicy stuff.
Oh, I get that all the time.
But the interesting part is that there were people in the Trump campaign who always seemed to have a bit of a lead on information that was going to come out, right? Roger Stone was one of them. He'd always have some kind of hint that he'd put out there that something was going to happen.
Well, keep in mind, we just still have bits and pieces of this whole story.
Right.
I mean, what you have to do is put this into the entire context going back to at least April of 2016, when we know Papadopoulos was told about these stolen documents from the DNC and presumably told people in the Trump campaign. And then you've got the June 3rd meeting with Ron Goldstone, who writes to Don Jr. saying, we've got all this highly incriminating material, and we're going to bring it to you on Hillary Clinton. And then you've got the other email that came out yesterday about how he had read about the hacked emails from the DNC and how it was very interesting, considering they just had this meeting at Trump Tower.
Right.
So you put all of this together, and then you see what happens right after the Trump Tower meeting, with documents being disseminated by Guccifer 2.0 and then being sent to WikiLeaks, and then all of the contacts among everybody in the campaign. I mean, what you really have developing here is a criminal conspiracy between the campaign and the Russian government to violate the federal computer crime law. You're dealing with documents that were hacked out of and stolen from a computer in the United States and then used for the purpose of undermining the Clinton campaign. And what we're looking at is, in the broad picture, is a criminal conspiracy which not only involves the campaign and people high up in the campaign, but various Russian actors and people aiding and abetting the Russians.
Who would name themselves Guccifer 2.0? Quickly, Donald Trump himself, though. There's a lot of talk because he's on this email. What about the defense that we could hear from the White House or from Trump's own lawyers? He's not an email user. So Donald Trump may have received an email, but they may be able to paint a picture that he never, ever uses email. He didn't just not respond to that one. But in general, the more we read about him and hear about him from guys like Corey Lewandowski in their book, not an email guy.
Well, that may be, but he certainly is a telephone guy. And you can just tell from those emails that occurred between June 4th and the June 9th meeting, there were lots of telephone calls that we don't know
about. With Manafort and with Jared Kushner as it related to that meeting.
Oh, lots of telephone calls.
There's some reference to Donald Trump's personal secretary in the email, so it would have been an effort to keep this away from Donald Trump.
Oh, you'd have to. I mean, I don't see how it could possibly be keeping it away from Donald Trump. In fact, we do know that on June 7th, he promised that the following week, this is June 7th, after he won the primary in New Jersey, he got on and said, I'm going to lay out all the dirty stuff we've got about the Clintons next week. Now, this is just after receiving the Goldstone email and all the phone calls that went in between. And then all of a sudden, the following week, he doesn't do it. And the obvious explanation is because they realize that possessing these stolen emails is a crime in itself. Yeah. It's a felony. So the only way they could get these emails disseminated out there to use in the election was to have a third party do it. And you've got Guccifer 2.0, you've got WikiLeaks, and then you've got Roger Stone, the hatchet man for the Trump campaign, who was involved with both ends of that equation.
Boy, oh boy. Nick, thank you so much.